choosing your plastic surgeon really comes down to getting the right information. Now, a lot of people just go on Google and they use a Google search and then they read reviews which are unvetted, unqualified, unverified, mostly anonymous postings, typically from angry patients. People that have 85 positive reviews on one site, that would be unusual. I think that you can do the math yourself. You can know that if your doctor has been in practice for 10 years and does 400 operations a year, and they have some positive reviews, that's great. But really it comes down to their credentials, training, where they practice, and getting a referral. I think if you can talk to their patients, if you can talk to other doctors about them, that's really your best way of choosing a plastic surgeon. Now, many people don't have a doctor that they can go to, so they'll read reviews from these review sites. But again, you know, it doesn't take much for people to skew the reviews, to make them positive, or in some cases make them very negative. And so that's a very unreliable method of choosing a physician. I do think that if you can find a doctor that you trust to get that referral and to go over, even if you do the research and say, well, I found this physician, the surgeon, and I'm thinking of having surgery with them, what do you think? Most of the family practice doctors, internal medicine doctors that we all go to and depend on can evaluate those credentials and tell you whether that's a good idea or not. A lot of people think that looking at the medical board site is useful. I mean, that's helpful. Obviously, if somebody has 12 different lawsuits on their record, you don't want to go to them. But it's all things coupled together. One of the most reliable ways of picking a physician is to look at their credentials at a local hospital. For instance, if you want to have a facelift by a doctor, you could call and say, oh, well, where do you have privileges to do that operation? And they might say, well, I don't do this in hospitals. But I can tell you that any of us that do a lot of facelifts who have a surgery center credential or a surgery center that we operate at, we all have privileges to do that operation at a local hospital. And that's kind of a telltale sign because that doctor then has been evaluated by the local hospital's administrative board. And so if they have those credentials at the local hospital, they are certainly credentialed to do your operation.